Welcome to the SCP Foundation Integrated File Server. To begin, please insert your Foundation personnel badge into the card reader. Authorization. Approved. Please select item's numerical code to view. Processing. Your file is ready to view.
Item hash. SCP-1919 Object Class. Euclid Special Containment Procedures. A zone with radius of 2.2 kilometers must be maintained surrounding SCP-1919. Any roads or paths leading to the building are to be diverted or obstructed. The perimeter of this zone is to be guarded by a set of no fewer than 25, 25, 40, 40, heavily armed and armored patrolmen. Those entering SCP-1919 shall not be giving body armor or weaponry. Any presence within the perimeter that is not confirmed to be a member of an expedition team is to be terminated immediately. The official report concerning Expedition 003 is to be accessed only by those currently researching SCP-1919 and those present for the incident itself. All copies of the report have been destroyed. Revised/:: As of Expedition 002. Under no circumstances is anyone to be allowed entry into SCP-1919 until all identified manifestations of SCP-1919-1 pertinent to the previous entrant or entrants have been eliminated, or until such time has elapsed that all manifestations can be expected to have starved to death. Description. SCP-1919 is an early 20th century hotel and converted mansion located in Komoda. As of Expedition 003, the building has sunk partially into the ground on the eastern side. It is still traversable, but additional safety precautions are necessary. From the outside, SCP-1919 looks much as it did when it was first built. On the inside, however, the building is massively decrepit and looks like it has been abandoned since its creation. Many floorboards and ceilings are rotten or absent entirely, and various forms of damage. For example, water damage, collapsed debris, cover much of the interior. Entry of the hotel by a human results in the appearance of a number of humanoid beings throughout the building, resembling the subject and wearing and carrying anything the subject possesses with them on arrival. These creatures, collectively labeled SCP-1919-1, typically vary from the original in several physical aspects. Observed variations between subjects and counterparts include the following: lack of body hair, misshapen cranial structure, patches of skin discoloration, variance in limb, digit length, disfigurement of the mouth sealed, missing eyelids, sealed nostrils, perforations of various sizes and skin elongated. Deformed jaw structure. SCP-1919-1 is responsible for the decrepit state of the building. Individuals have been recorded upending furniture, tearing out floorboards, damaging pipes, and otherwise causing small-scale destruction. The fact that they are capable of this makes the reason why to date only three, have attempted to escape the building unclear. All observed creatures labeled SCP-1919-1 have behaved in a similar manner. Individually, they act aggressively with or without provocation, attempting to damage objects and structures at random. They also demonstrate a marked increase in hostility once they locate the subject or subjects who enter SCP-1919. See Expedition Logs 001, 002. This behavior, however, seems not to extend to each other. Rather, they are predisposed to form large, coordinated groups upon encountering more of their kind. The largest observed group thus far contained members and was responsible for incapacitating Task Force Tau 11, Youth Hostiles. As a whole, SCP-1919-1 exhibits a swarm intelligence akin to that of an ant colony. It is yet unknown specifically how they communicate, but they have proven to be able to do so quickly and non-verbally. While unverified as of /:: all signs point to SCP-1919-1 possessing an organ system that allows it to send and receive signals via pheromones. The fact that killing or wounding one, even noiselessly and out of the presence of others, attracts all within an estimated 40-meter radius directly toward the one harmed corroborates this. Addendum 1919-01 Expedition 003-CP-1919-1 cause only one immediate fatality among TF Tau 11. The rest of the task force was disfigured in many of the same ways as their duplicates. Video footage suggests that this change in behavior was deliberate and not the result of successful self-defense. And succumbed to their injuries within a week of leaving the building. Despite sustaining severe damage to the lower jaw, was reported by medical staff to have repeated the phrase in the picture intermittently before falling unconscious. Died en route to Foundation treatment facilities. Addendum 1919-02 After analyzing footage from Expedition 003, it has come to the Foundation's attention that a being located inside the building is responsible for the creation of all observed instances of SCP-1919-1. The new primary objective of all efforts concerning the SCP is the identification, retrieval, and containment of said being. In confronting her, researchers are instructed to data expunged.